In this corner of Arizona, on the border of Mexico, in the Chiricahua Mountains, there's this wonderful research station called the Southwest Research Station. It's at the epicenter of hot diversity of ants.
I'm not sure why it matters. It's just something that a lot of people study.
We estimate that there are 30,000 ant species in the world. We just know 16,000, so we still have half of those ants to be discovered.
Well, ant diversity is part of a larger question of why there's such a plethora of life on the planet, from the tiniest bacteria and viruses to the largest redwoods and whales.
People often ask me, well, why just focus on ants? But there are more species of ants than all the birds and mammals added together.
So we can answer that question with respect to ants, but honestly, understanding the diversity of life is just one of those things that I think we should attach intrinsic value to. It's understanding the world around us.
So when I was a graduate student, I became fascinated with ants, but had nothing or nobody to really teach me about ants. And I decided that when I graduated, I would start this course called Ant Course, in which I could take students from all different backgrounds, those that study the chemistry of ants, those that study the evolution, the behavior, the ecology, and make this course where they all learn from each other about ant systematics, taxonomy, and we really kind of jump ant study into the modern world.
You have those ants that are rare and no one can find them. And it's like looking for a treasure, and you only find it. You feel your heart beating fast and you want to tell everyone, I found it.
Everybody knows what ants are. There's a word for ant in every language. Whenever I go to dinner parties, pretty soon everybody's kind of around me as I tell stories about ants. It kind of captures people's attention.